Hello and welcome everybody! Today we are in Oosthout, in Voorhout, and we're going to find out which hack has the most power, which hack has the most control, and which hack should you get. And we're going to start right now. Vamos! Before we start, let's try to get this video up to 500 likes. Please let me know, would you like to see more in depth about the specs of the racket, or would you rather have that I talk about how it feels for me? How does the racket feel for me? Is it comfort, power, everything? Easy to play with, more with the hands? Please let me know if you want me something to describe about the racket that I'm going to test, so I can make these videos as good as possible. Vamos! Okay, so there's a little bit of a difference between the rackets. So the green one is comfort, so maybe that's more the comfort racket. It's a little bit thicker, but more diamond shape. This one is slightly rounder. Both are high in balance, so then you will have the most power as you will possibly have. This one could be slightly heavier, and this one could be slightly lighter. But it really depends on the factory, because that's not always the same. So if you see a racket 360 between 375, then it doesn't mean it's always 360 or 375. That's the range. Volley test! Vamos! Full power mode. Hecky, hecky, hecky. Heck, 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 heck. What the heck? The sweet spot is very, very small. So you have to hit the ball exactly right. If you don't hit the ball correctly, it's not going to be very good. So this is a racket that you should get if your timing is on a really high level. So these are professional level rackets, and for all the Bullpadel rackets, the hack ones are the most difficult ones to play with. So only get this racket if you think your timing is good. To be honest, my timing is not the best in the world, so for me, I wouldn't choose a racket like this. I would go a little bit, not to professional level, but I would go slightly more towards the Vertex if I have to choose a Bullpadel racket. De Dejada test. Okay, so with the Dejada, with the drop shot, I would choose this one. For me, when the ball hits this racket, it goes into the racket, it goes there, and then it comes out. And for me, this feels like it's a wall. So you do this, boom, and the ball goes over the net. I like to play a lot with my wrist, so then I prefer this one. But if you are, if you like to block, if you like to play flat, if you want to play hard, then this is your racket. This is a machine. You can do this and the ball goes over the net. It's so powerful when you hit the ball fast. But with the Dejada, you have to adjust your technique. It's just this, boom, and the ball will go. And with this one, you can make your motion slightly longer. So for a technique that is quite small and compact, you can choose this. If you have a longer technique, you can choose this. Or if you like to play with your hands, This is your racket. De bandeja test. So you have to hit the ball so well to generate power, and I feel like the other hack, you just have to do this and the ball goes with the bandeja. I prefer this because I like to play with slice. This one goes super, super fast. So you can kill anybody on the court with this racket. This is a killer. This is more control, and it does have enormous amounts of power. I think both rackets or for somebody that hits the ball very, very hard. So yeah, but yeah, let's find out how the smash will go. That will be very interesting. The saco por tres test, tío. With smashing the ball, these are machines, but you have to hit the ball correctly. If you don't hit the ball into the middle or on the sweet spot, it's not gonna be amazing. So then the ball will die on your racket. So get this racket when you have a very good timing. With the smash, I preferred this one because I just did this and the ball goes. With this one, you have slightly more control. So percentage wise, I could kick the ball out of the court more often with this one. But when I kick the ball with this one, it goes further. The Vertex 03 has more control than the Hack ones. So I think you go to Hack if you want to have more power, and you have to go slightly more to Vertex if you want more control. And the Vertex 03 was the most control. If you want slightly more control, then you should watch the video about the Vertex rackets below. If you want to play with Bullpadel. Vamos. Shit, bro. So all in all, this is a racket that's difficult to play with. Only play with this racket if your technique is correct, if you have a very good timing, and if you want to hit hard. If you are a beginner, then this is not your racket. If you are an advanced player, this could be your racket. These are rackets that a left side player will play with, not like somebody that builds up the point. So that's why Paquito plays with this racket, because he can kick the ball out of the court easier with the racket. And he has a very good timing. These six rackets that we reviewed are all Proline rackets. So that's the most advanced rackets that you can possibly play with. So from all Bullpadel Proline rackets, these are the most powerful rackets. And if you want to have less power and more control, you can go more to Proline Vertex. And if you want to have more control, you might need to choose anything else than the Pro line of Bullpadel. If you want to see any more reviews about rackets, let me know below which brand you want to see next. And I will see you in the next episode. Hasta luego. Ciao. Adios.